Hello students, so now today we will study about decision statement. In last session we have discussed about input function and we obtained the values from the user and used that values in our program. So now today we will do decision statement. So let's move forward. This we have covered everything. I also told you about the conversion method yesterday. So you can use integer and float functions to convert a string into integer and float respectively. And this is a program, input program. You have to find the average of three values inputted by the user. So here we have used input. This I taught you yesterday. And all these things, you can execute this program at your own and find the output. But our objective of today is decision structure. So what if you need to print different message on the basis of your decision? Suppose if there is rain outside, you want to print a message, I will not go to market. Otherwise you want to print a message, I will go to market. So your message is depending on a condition, that whether it is rain going on outside or not. So here in the above example, the message is dependent on a condition of raining. Simple applying print message will not work because it will not check the condition. So what should be done? For this purpose, to print different message based on the conditions result, either true or false, we will use decision structure. Python supports if else decision structure, and we will use this if else statement, which is also known as decision statement. So let me show you. This is the decision. So in decision structure, we make decision, and according to the decision, the appropriate message or the block of code executed. So if else statement syntax is given here. Okay, if, and then there is condition, there is a block of statement based on this condition. If this condition evaluates to true, this block of statement will execute. Otherwise, if condition becomes false, then this block of statement will execute. Means at a time only one block of statement will execute, and it totally depends on condition. Okay, if the condition is true, then this section will execute, otherwise this section will execute. So in this way you can apply a condition, and based on a condition you can execute any of the one block. If condition return true, if condition evaluate to true, then if part will execute, otherwise else part will execute. Is it okay? Everyone clear here? So this is known as block one. This is block one. This portion is known as block one, and this portion is block two. So what is block here? A block is a group of statement, or you can say the statements that are written at the same indent. Indent, what is indent? This is the space. This space is known as indent. You can say this space is known as indent. And you can see these statements are written at a same indent. So these are forming a block. These statements are written at same indent. So these are forming another block. Okay. So the statement which are written at same indent are known as forming a block. Is it okay? Next. So this is the syntax of if statement. Now how to apply this syntax? Let's take one example. Program to check whether inputted number is positive or negative. How will you check a number is positive or negative? When a number is negative, when you can say a number is negative? Yes, when number is less than 0, it means it's a negative. And if it is greater than or equal to 0, then it's a positive number. So first of all, in any program, you know, there are three things. One is the input, another one is process, and third one is output. So what you need to get to check whether the number is input or not, first of all, we need to get a number from the user. So take an input from user. Input, write the first statement like this. Input, enter a number, and then convert it into integer, because you are taking a number. So convert it into integer. You know, input always return a string value. So you need to convert it and then put it in a num variable. Now, if this num is greater than 0, you have placed 0, you have applied which operator here? You have applied relational operator. Greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to, all these are relational operator. So we are relating two values and checking whether num is greater than 0. If yes, then print it's a positive number. Otherwise, you need to print it's a negative number. So you can see simply on this condition, based on this condition, either this statement will execute or this will execute. Okay, so this is the block 1 and this is block 2. Now you can observe we have applied a condition, num is greater than 0. If number is greater than 0, then it will display number is positive. Otherwise, it will show number is negative. So we can do it practically. I'm showing it. First of all, you have to open Python and then file, new, and then type the program. So first of all, we have to take a number is equal to int input, enter a number. Okay, enter a number. Now we want to check this number. There are two brackets in the beginning, so we have to close two brackets. Now we have taken the value from the user as well as we have converted it into integer. Now check if num is greater than 0. Now this is the part, syntax part, colon you have to apply and then press enter. Automatically it will set your cursor at the indent level. Okay, now put the value, put the message print, because when num is greater than 0, it means greater than and equal, greater than or equal, both condition. In both cases number is positive. Number is positive. Okay, else you have to put in the, because if the else is the part of if statement, so you have to keep the else by decreasing the indent. So we have click the indent, because if is the else is the part of if, so we have to keep if and else at the same indent. Now again press enter and write print number is negative. Okay, and close the bracket. Now we will execute it, but before executing we have to save it. Save as, and then choose the location where to save. C colon users and then sample 8. Okay, now I have saved my file and then I am pressing F5. When I press F5, it is asking a number. Suppose I have given -9. What will you get? It's a negative number. Yes, number is negative. If you want to execute again, then what we have to do? Again, we will go into program. Yes, and then print F5. Enter a number. Suppose I have given 56. What will you get? You will get number is positive. So our program is working fine. Is it? Okay. Now, this is our one program which we have covered on basis of if else or decision structure, you can call it. Now another program you do at your own. I'm giving you one, elaborating one problem. Write a program to check whether person is eligible to vote or not. Write a program to check whether a person is eligible to vote or not. Now tell me, who is eligible to participate in voting process? Who can vote? Yes, the person whose age is greater than or equal to 18 years. They can vote. Okay, so they can give vote. Now, you have to do the program accordingly. Okay, do this exercise. Thank you. Now your Python is over here. That's all from my side. Thank you so much.